know, you boy in the corner there, you ought to be a Boy Scout. You're a fine-looking fella, and I know you'd make a jolly good backwoodsman by the look of you.
Baden Powell was born on February 22, 1857, in Paddington, London, United Kingdom. He was the 8th of 10 children of Reverend Baden Powell and Henrietta Grace Powell. Three of Powell's siblings, Henrietta, John, and Jesse, died in infancy before Powell was even born. When Powell was 3 years old, his father died of pneumonia. When he was 19, he began serving in the British Army. Powell joined the 13th Hussars in India, ranking lieutenant. Powell was stationed in India, Afghanistan, and South Africa. Powell created the Boy Scouts because when he was serving in the Army, his troops did not know basic first aid or how to survive outdoors. Baden Powell thought it was his responsibility to solve this problem. He then created a small handbook called Aids to Scouting, which mainly stated how to be resourceful, adaptable, and how to lead. In 1907, Baden Powell wanted to test his idea of Boy Scouting by putting 20 boys on the Brown Sea Island off the coast of southern England. They set up a small camp that the boys would live in for 12 days. His test was successful. The 20 boys cherished their time on the island. They could go hiking, canoeing, and all in between. It was the perfect experience for boys of all ages.
The really essential meaning of scouting to Baden Powell, it was, above all things, an escape. He felt deeply attracted to boyhood in a way that subsequent generations didn't. And the wonderful thing for Baden Powell and for many scoutmasters was that through scouting you could rediscover it and re-enter the magic world of boyhood. Baden Powell sometimes talked about himself as being a boy man, and he suggested to scoutmasters that they'd understand boys much better if they could relearn boyhood and become boy men. It was an escape from responsibility, and it was escape from women, from having to think about his own sexuality, from everything. It was a kind of return to boyhood where he could be free, free of the competitiveness which his mother had forced on him, and able really to somehow rediscover what he'd lost.
From what I've heard, Boy Scouts came to America. There was an American businessman. He was a Chicago publisher, I believe, William Boyce. And he was on a business trip in London, lost in the fog. And a young scout came across him and helped him find his way to where he needed to go. Mr. Boyce offered him a tip to say thank you, and the boy turned it down and told him that he was doing his good turn for the day, and could not accept a tip. And Mr. Boyce thought that was very interesting and wanted to learn more about scouting.
At the time, a number of troops already existed based on the British concept of Boy Scouts. Boyce felt it was his right to turn this into an organization, the Boy Scouts of America. Boyce provided funding towards the creation of this organization, but let key YMCA members lead the program. For the first year, the Boy Scouts were led by the YMCA. The new BSA blossomed by them quickly establishing a national office, developing a temporary handbook, seeking out Baden Powell's endorsement, which they got, and continuing the effort begun by Boyce to get a congressional charter from the U.S. Congress. Then they began to absorb other BSA-like organizations. They all joined by 1912. As Boyce was making the BSA, he was struggling to get it up and running. He was confronted by a man named Edgar Robinson. Edgar Robinson was the first Boyce work secretary of the YMCA's International Committee. Boyce and Robinson were both intrigued by the Boy Scout idea, and they needed help getting it up and running. They enlisted the help of Ernest Thompson and Carter Beard. These four men were able to work together to start the Boy Scouts of America. Carter Beard was appointed to the position of First Scout Commissioner. James E. West was hired as the Chief Scout Executor, but he and Boyce did not work well together, so Boyce left the BSA. William Boyce decided to create his own scouting organization, the Lone Scouts of America. In 1924, Boyce decided to merge the Lone Scouts of America with the Boy Scouts of America, and it became the Boy Scouts of America once again. As Baden-Powell grew older, he met his wife, Olive St. Clair Soames, on a ship called the Arcadian at age 55. He married Miss Soames, who was 23 years old, and they had three children. Powell thought about the play Peter Pan and decided that he should do what the chief pirate did in the play. He gave the last message speech even though he was perfectly healthy. On January 8, 1941, Baden-Powell died. He was 83 years old and is buried in a simple grave at Nyeri, within sight of Mount Kenya. On his headstones are the words Robert Baden-Powell, Chief Scout of the World, surmounted by the Boy Scout and Girl Scout badges. His memory remains for all time in the hearts of millions of men and women, boys and girls.
What's amazing to me is that a man who led such a admittedly bizarre life should, 50 years after his death, have ended up with a worldwide movement of 25 million people who are proud enough to call themselves Scouts.
Today, a Boy Scout can have the experience of a lifetime. They can go to summer camps, earn merit badges, and exert their boyhood. A lot has changed since Powell first started Boy Scouts.
Yes, there's Sea Scouts, which are just scouts that do a lot of sailing and water sport recreational activities. There's Venture Scouts, and those are usually people who go out and do high adventure camping and hiking and stuff. Both of these are co-ed camping and adventuring experiences. And there's also the Order of the Arrow, which is an organization within the Boy Scouts for members that achieve right of being initiated into the Order of the Arrow.
After 104 years of improvements, the Boy Scouts is the largest movement in the world, with Powell getting a new follower every 5 seconds. Today, there are over 32 million Scouts worldwide and growing. There are also 120 different merit badges spanning from animal science to wilderness survival. They also added a new program called the Tiger Cubs, which was added to Cub Scouting.
Probably Philmont, which is a high adventure scout camp. It was my favorite just because it helped build me as a human being and helped show that I could cooperate with people towards the end, and it just taxed. It was very physically and mentally taxing to hike across the rugged terrain for 10 days with a bunch of people who some I liked and some I didn't like, and we all got along towards the end and we all made everything work, and it was a great experience.
My favorite scouting experience was actually as an adult leader. Scouting has something that's called high adventure, and I enjoy doing that with my older son and the crew that we were with. We went sailing in the Keys. Another one involved canoeing up in Ontario. And the last one was the Philmont Boy Scout ranch out of New Mexico, where we hiked nearly 100 miles, and that was a wonderful trip.
Baden-Powell would be very proud of what we've done with the Boy Scouts.